Character, culture, and Christ have been the motto for Southern Nazarene University for many, many years. When I came as president, I was really curious about those words and really curious to dig into the archives. In fact, a conversation on campus one day with a visitor to our campus who asked that same question, what does character, culture, and Christ mean today? These days, I like to talk about refining character. I think that we're all in process, and in those collegiate years, those years of a university experience, there's a great opportunity to refine character.
Renew is the University Counseling Center. We are located at 6710 Northwest 43rd Street, just north of the Webster Commons. Renew offers a variety of services, including individual counseling, couples counseling, and psychoeducational workshops. The first 5 sessions for students are free, and students will never pay more than $10 per session. Faculty counseling is just $40 per session. Renew is open Monday through Thursday from 9 a.m. to 8 p.m. and Fridays from 11 a.m. until 6 p.m. For more information, visit renew.snu.edu or email renew@mail.snu.edu.
Favorite things about SNU was the relationships I was able to have with people, with professors, with friends.
One thing that was purposely different about SNU was the integration of faith into the academics. I feel like I learned so much from that helped prepare me for life after college, to be a husband and someday to be a father. It was a really, really transformational time in my life.
My degree could have come from anywhere, but my relationships with people, I know I would not have gotten anywhere else. Go to snu.edu to apply or to schedule a visit.
And we welcome you into Phelan Field for a GAC conference matchup between the Southern Nazarene University Crimson Storm and the Henderson State Reddies out of Arkadelphia, Arkansas. I'm Grant McNew. That's Desmond Williams. Desmond, this is baseball season.
Oh man, what a beautiful day out today. 76 degrees.
Yes.
Wind going out about 13 miles an hour.
Straight out.
Oh man, I can't wait.
I tell you what, and it feels like 74 too, and it's one of those days that you just, man, you can feel the baseball in the air. It smells like baseball, and I am so excited for this matchup. Listen to this. Southern Nazarene right now, 10th in the GAC, sitting at 6-18 in conference play. Here they're going to face off against number 8 in the conference, who sits 13-11 in conference play. Starting pitchers today, Levi Graham for SNU, Kyle Williams for Henderson State. Let's take a look at the standings. I want to cover something up here. We usually go into lineups and stuff right here, but we got something important to look at here for for this. Conference standings on the screen. You can read those. Northwestern, Arkansas Tech, Arkansas Monticello, all the way down. The top eight make the conference tournament. Here's where we stand, okay? Here's where we stand. Southern Nazarene sitting at 10th with 6 wins in conference play. Nine total conference games left on the season. Henderson State, here in front of you, has 13 as the number 8 seed. But here's what I want to point out, okay? Southwestern Oklahoma State, a spot above you with 11 total wins. They might not win another game. The remaining schedule for Southwestern Oklahoma State is number 4 SAU, who has touched first in conference recently. That is at home against SAU. Then they go on to play UAM, Arkansas Monticello, in Monticello. Arkansas Monticello is number 3 in conference. They have recently touched number 1 in conference. Then they go on to play Northwestern Oklahoma State at home. Northwestern Oklahoma State, number 1 in conference. That's a big 3 series for SWATSU. That's 1 in conference, 3 in conference, 4 in conference. All 3 of those have touched number 1 in about the last month. Then you go on to number 8 in conference. This is Henderson State, who's going to play you. You're playing Southern Nazarene University. They go on to play Oklahoma Baptist and Ouachita. Here's what's interesting about these three teams. Henderson State, 13 wins. Ouachita Baptist, who sits at number 7, 13 wins. I believe we're getting starting lineups going. I want to make sure I don't talk over the national anthem here. I don't think they will. Where was I? Ouachita Baptist, 13 wins. Oklahoma Baptist, 13 wins. That is 6, 7, and 8 in conference, all at 13 wins on the season in conference play. So the remaining games, the remaining series for Southern Nazarene University goes like this. You've got Henderson State, then you go on to Arkadelphia to play Ouachita Baptist, and then you're in Shawnee for Oklahoma Baptist. Those are the 8, 7, and 6 teams in conference play. Now, we've already covered that SWATSU likely going to win 1 or 2 games. There's a real chance they don't win another game this season. So you feel like if you can win out, you will have 15 wins, will automatically jump Southwestern Oklahoma State. So you only need 1 spot in conference play. Henderson State plays you, Oklahoma Baptist, and Ouachita. Ouachita plays Oklahoma Baptist, Southern Nazarene, Henderson State. Oklahoma Baptist plays Ouachita, Henderson State, Southern Nazarene. So what you need is 1 team to drop the season, to get ganged up on by your remaining schedule. Let's take a break and sit on that for a minute. Ladies and gentlemen, we have...
Character, culture, and Christ have been the motto for Southern Nazarene University for many, many years. When I came as president, I was really curious about those words and really curious to dig into the archives. In fact, a conversation on campus one day with a visitor to our campus who asked that same question, what does character, culture, and Christ mean today? These days, I like to talk about refining character. I think that we're all in process, and in those collegiate years, those years of a university experience, there's a great opportunity to refine character.
Well, we bring you back into the booth after that chaotic explanation of the rest of the season. I'm sorry for that, but also, it's exciting stuff. There's a chance. You're telling me there's a chance.
Oh, there's a chance.
Oh, man. Hey, let's take a look at the lineup for Henderson State. They're going to start off with Cal Jones in right field, then Caden Argenbright over at shortstop. Luke Farah going to be over at second base, then Luke Rice on first base. Louis Holton left field, Mitch Siegel as the DH, then Landon Irvin behind the dish. Dylan Thomas over at third base, and Nate Moore in center field will round out the lineup. For the fielding side for Southern Nazarene, Levi Graham getting the starting call here in game one of the series. So Levi Graham on the bump, Entwistle behind the dish, Hicks on first, Leone on second, Brinkmeyer on third, Tucker LeMay is at shortstop. Then from left to right in the outfield, Hudson, Martinez, Dias, and Trey Orman will be your designated hitter. Oh man, it starts here, Desmond. Here's the thing, here's the key. We just went over the possibility of Southern Nazarene likely not making it, likely not getting to the postseason, but call me a conspiracy theorist, call me crazy, there is a chance. There's a real chance. So it starts here today. It starts here right now. You can't lose another game. Maybe if you're lucky, you get away with dropping one, but losing at home, not an option for Southern Nazarene. Cal Jones at the plate, first pitch to him off the mark. We will call ball one. Graham brings in the 1-0. That will turn to 2-0. So 3-0 count now, Levi Graham working against Jones, the right fielder. Desmond, I guess I could be using my scorebook. Graham gonna hit Jones, send him to first. Now runner on first as Jones brings up Argenbright. Now Carson Kennard in the booth for the first time this season. How about that?
Oh, this is gonna be a good time. It's a different type of view up here. Kind of like it.
It really is a different view. You're usually out on the field. That's probably a little more fun.
Yeah, it is more fun for sure.
So Graham hits his first batter. Argenbright now to the plate.
And I believe Entwistle got hit in a place you really don't want to get hit.
Those are always tough. Put you down for a few seconds for sure.
Now Argenbright at the plate, first pitch to him, called strike one, first strike of the day for Graham. Again, this Henderson State team is solid. They sit at number 8 right now in conference play. 13 conference win on the year for them. Like we said, Desmond, each game for this point for Southern Nazarene is massive.
Absolutely. Starts right here.
Levi Graham, that pitch gotta be caught! Hicks! Line drive down the first baseline. Double play, no help needed.
It's really good stuff. Levi's throwing really, really well as he played his last 3 or 4 outings.
Boy, how often do you see a double play like that as Farah comes to the plate batting righty? First pitch to Farah, strike one. Levi Graham, a 7-4 ERA his last time out against Southeastern Oklahoma State, 4 even innings. Now 1-1 count.
His ERA really doesn't show you how well he's been throwing. He started off rough this year coming out of the pen, but once they put him on the mound as a starter, he's throwing really, really well.
1-1 turns to 2-1. Yeah, to your point, Carson, every single game that he's pitched, his ERA has either improved or only gone up by 0.7.
He's given us some really good outings as a starter.
2-1, swung on, fouled off to the right side. Now a 2-2 count against Farah, the second baseman, number 3 in the lineup. Two's hot, on the board. No one on. A 2-2. Graham loads, deals outside. A full count now for Farah. Levi delivers just outside. They'll give him the walk. What you think on that one, Carson?
That one's off, I think. It's kind of in the alley, you know, in between the batter's box and the plate. It's a tough pitch to take, but if depends on how the umpire is that day, you know, it can go either way. Usually, all the GAC umpires are tied to start the game, and as it goes on, their zones will always get bigger.
Oh, man. Luke Rice at the plate, the first baseman, a 6'1". 6'1" junior out of Little Rock, Arkansas. Transferred in from UA Rich Mountain. Go Antlers.
Yeah, I played him in junior college.
Really?
Yes, I did.
He's got a 325 average now and a 2-0 count to his name. Any bad blood there, Carson?
No, we weren't real fond of Rich Mountain, but he was a good player. We didn't ever talk too much, but every year we played him, he was always a good hitter.
No home runs for him this season, but again, a 325 average, been incredibly consistent for the Reddies. A single machine. Now the 2-1. Go, 2-2. I think we got some lawnmowers out today.
We do. Seems like they're out there mowing the hill right now.
Two balls, two strikes. Graham gonna catch a man trying to head to second. The throw to LeMay is high. Nobody's covering third. And so Farah, who likely should have been out at second, will advance to third. But Graham made the right decision. Sent it to Hicks. LeMay couldn't snow cone the ball over at second, and Farah takes advantage of Brinkmeyer coming over. Now 2-2 the count. Runner on third, two outs on the board. Graham delivers, swung on, fouled off left side. If you're Henderson State, how aggressive you feeling here?
It's early in the game, two outs, runner on third. You know, anything, you want to put anything in play right now.
Now the 2-2's outside, 3-2 count. Yeah, and if you want anybody putting it in play, it's going to be Rice if you're Henderson State. Give him a 2-2 count. I do believe the home plate umpire is mistaken. Pitch on the way. Off the mark. Three balls, two strikes. Couple of outs. Big pitch on the way for Graham. And the wind blowing out towards left field. Payoff pitch. Swung on. Fouled off again. Tough at bat for Rice. A tough out. Levi Graham is still looking for it. What pitch you calling for here?
Man, I come back with Levi's best pitch. It's usually his fastball.
That ball's going to get by, reach the netting, and plate one off of the walk. So Farah gets around. He reached third on an error. That will be the first score for Henderson State. Back-to-back walks for Levi Graham. That was a tough at-bat earned by Rice. Now Louis Holt, the left fielder, batting lefty. First pitch to Holt, a rocket towards right field. Dias just going to have to watch that one go. It bounces over the hill. An absolute shot from Louis Holt. A two-run bomb. And it's 3-0 Henderson State. Two out hitting, huge for Southern Nazarene most of the season. Now Henderson State coming right back with it here in the top of the first. Siegel now, the DH at the plate. First pitch from Graham, called strike one. Well, you feel like Levi's done what he's needed to do, just a couple unfortunate happenings.
Yeah. All their hitters have done a good job battling when they got in deep counts. Made him really throw a lot of pitches here in this first inning.
One ball, one strike, no one on. Levi Graham looking to get out of the first. Siegel takes strike two. One, two, Graham. Loads, deals, swung on, hit high towards center field. Martinez underneath it. Martinez makes the catch. So three runs scored for Henderson State. Guys, what do you think about that inning?
Not ideal, not what you want, but we get the bats going right here, we're right back in it.
I agree with him, you know. Really not what you want to see from that, an early first inning, but sometimes that happens. You got plenty of game left. You just got to go do what y'all do.
Absolutely right. Hey, the first three up for Southern Nazarene will be Entwistle, Brinkmeyer, and Hicks. A solid three, but really all nine in the lineup have been outstanding as of late. Again, you just came off of a run rule against Northwestern Oklahoma State where the bats were hot, and that was an understatement.
All the guys have been swinging it really well as of late, so no matter what, I think we will turn this into a dogfight.
They'll have to come out and face Kyle Williams. A 5.55 ERA from him. His last appearance was at Arkansas Monticello. He threw 3 1/3. In those three innings, he allowed 6 hits and 7 earned runs. Still had 3 Ks and a couple walks. A guy that, you know, if you can put the bat on it early, you're feeling good. You just have to get over to his head. He's not going to walk very many. Boy, that was a treat having Carson Kennard for a half inning, wasn't it?
It's beautiful. Great guy.
Great guy. Let's take a look at the field. For Henderson State, Kyle Williams on the bump, Irvin behind the dish, then Rice, Farah, Thomas, and Argenbright holding down the infield. Holt, Moore, Jones in the outfield, and Siegel, the DH. You won't see him defensively. The lineup for Southern Nazarene. Colby Entwistle starting things off, and Blake Brinkmeyer batting second, Weston Hicks third, Jacob Martinez handling the cleanup duties, and Trey Orman DHing here in game one of the three-game series. Chase Hudson, Max Dias, and then Alex Leon and Tucker LeMay will round things out. You need it here, Desmond. You need it here.
Yeah. Really use a couple runs here early. Give yourself a little confidence going into these next innings.
Colby Entwistle against Williams, hoping to get on him early. If you can get on him early, if you can do it, what good things can really happen. Henderson State prepared for that. However, they do have already some movement in the bullpen. Bad news here, Desmond. I forgot my rangefinder.
Oh.
I don't have it.
Oh.
I don't have it. Can't see. First pitch to Entwistle, going to be called ball one.
You're actually blind right now.
I am. My eyes are closed. My eyes are closed.
Is it in your truck?
It is in my truck. It's in my truck. 1-0 now from Williams to Entwistle. On the stretch. Entwistle gets that one. Going to drop in center field. Colby Entwistle. A good bat. He barreled that one. Got it down. So Entwistle, leadoff single, will bring up Blake Brinkmeyer. And Brinkmeyer, the man on first, no outs, batting lefty against Kyle Williams. First pitch to the freshman. We'll call it ball one. This is the thing about SNU's hitting, Desmond, I think is really interesting for Kyle Williams, is the fact that they've been so disciplined on what not to swing at. 37 strikeouts and 29 walks tells you he's trying to get people reaching. Now the 1-0 turns to 2-0. Southern Nazarene, this is what they did to UAM. They don't reach.
Absolutely. They've been really good at that as of late, and I really expect them to continue that success.
Now the 2-0. Williams. Loads, deals, outside for ball three. Boy, if Austin Schoenfeld is somewhere watching, he should make his way to the ballpark and come get my rangefinder for me out of my truck. Now the 3-0 will turn to 3-1. So Williams avoids a four-ball walk. Now he's back into this at-bat. Hicks is on deck for Southern Nazarene. Jacob Martinez in the hole. The 3-1 from Williams. Swung on. Brinkmeyer bounced that one up the middle. Going to be a slow roll. Brinkmeyer can't beat the throw. He's thrown out at first. But Entwistle is able to advance to second. That's hit you feel like if he's a sophomore, junior, senior. Brinkmeyer's able to beat out with a little extra speed, but as of right now, just barely gets called out. Now Weston Hicks to the plate. First pitch to Hicks off the mark.
Yeah, when we talked about Williams probably trying to get those guys to chase, pretty much every ball I've seen has just been right outside of the zone.
Well, Hicks is going to pop this one up over to second base. Farrah tracking it down. What a tough grab. It nearly bounced out of his glove, but Farrah able to hold on to it.
It's a really impressive catch. I'm honestly not sure if he should have caught that or the right fielder should have came up and got that.
Either way, it's going to be tough. Now, Jacob Martinez, the center fielder, to the plate. Martinez, a transfer out of Grand Canyon, will check, get strike one. Native of Ventura, California. A long trip out here to Oklahoma City. Bethany to be exact. Now the 0-1, the runner on second. Two outs. Pitch on the way. Martinez going to get this down in left field. Entwistle rounding third. He's going to head home. Colby Entwistle, no throw home. So an RBI single from Jacob Martinez brings Colby back to the dugout as run number one for Southern Nazarene. Now Trey Orman to the plate for SNU. Two outs, runner on first. Trailing by a couple in the bottom of the first. First pitch to Orman, swung on the ground towards third, picked up by Thomas. He's just gonna send it to second and get out number three. So a lot of contact for SNU. That's what you like to see, Desmond, isn't it?
Absolutely, and what a great job by Martinez executing that pitch and getting it out there to left field, letting Entwistle use his wheels that normally catchers don't have, but you know, he's got some wheels on him. Manages to get home without any throw.
Let's take a break, step away, and get ready for the second inning. You're watching Southern Nazarene Baseball on the Call Sports Network.
Character, culture, and Christ have been the motto for Southern Nazarene University for many, many years. When I came as president, I was really curious about those words and really curious to dig into the archives. In fact, a conversation on campus one day with a visitor to our campus who asked that same question, what does character, culture, and Christ mean today? These days, I like to talk about refining character. I think that we're all in process, and in those collegiate years, those years of a university experience, there's a great opportunity to refine character.
Well, we bring you back into Phelan Field. We're in the bottom part of the lineup for Henderson State. Irvin, Thomas, and Moore, who bring up 7, 8, and 9 before Jones from the top of the lineup can get a chance. So for Southern Nazarene, here's what you're looking to do. More of the same, just hope things don't fall the way they did.
Yeah, you know, last inning, just kind of a rough inning, but luckily on the offensive side, you were able to get one back. Started chipping away early, and that's what you like to see.
So Irvin to the plate, facing Levi Graham. Landon Irvin, a senior out of Forney, Texas, hitting 316 so far this season. The 0-1 count against him. Now it turns to 1-1. One ball, one strike. Graham delivers. Just outside, 2-1. Now the 2-1 from Graham on the way. That one's hit to LeMay on the ground. Tough hop. He makes the grab, sends it to first. Got him. Hicks makes the dig. One out on the board. It's a tough play by LeMay.
Hot off the bat.
Yes. Now Dylan Thomas, the third baseman. First pitch to him, called ball one. Thomas, a senior from Cabot, Arkansas. Go Panthers. That one swung on, hit high and back. It's in foul territory. Is it going to be in play? No, it won't. 1-1.
Almost hit a fan. That wouldn't have been good.
No. Thomas transferred to Henderson State from Mineral Area Community College. Mineral Area. I've never heard of it, have you?
I have not.
Interesting. Interesting. 253 average for him this season. I wonder if it's going to be like the Thunder Ducks.
I don't think you can beat the Thunder Ducks.
No, you can't. Oh my goodness, what a breaking ball from Levi Graham. 1-2, got him swinging.
That was disgusting.
Now the 1-2 from Graham, swung on. That one's in play in right field. It's high and will fall foul. Dyes couldn't get there. Would have been a tough catch. It may have snuck over the field wall by the bullpen. So 1-2 count, one out on the board, no one on. Oh, they're just the Cardinals. Mineral Area is.
Oh, that's cool.
Not cool. That pitch off the mark now turns to 2-2. I mean, it was a bird, so kind of Thunder Ducky.
But not so Thunder Ducky.
But not, yeah. 2-2 on the way, outside, ball three. Nate Moore on deck for Henderson State.
Graham really trying to get that curveball to hit, but just keeps leaving it outside.
We got a time call on the field. Now Levi Graham, 3-2 count. One out, payoff pitch on the way, foul ball.
I think one of the Henderson pitchers warming up might have thrown the ball onto the field.
That's not a good sign, not a good sign. That ball swung on, hit softly to Leon. It bounces up to him. There's out number two. So Alex Leon able to make the play. Bit of an awkward bounce, but it just kind of fell into his glove. Now Nate Moore, the sophomore from Bossier Parish Community College, steps up to the plate, former Cavalier. Now a 213 average.
Yeah, as an infielder, that's probably the best bad hop you can get.
Oh yeah.
The one that just falls right to you.
Moore, with 19 hits this season on 89 at-bats, has a 1-0 count against him. He's got 12 RBIs as well. That ball swung on, hit high, in play, shallow right field. Drifting over is Leon, and Alex gets out number three. Three up, three down for the Crimson Storm. They are now back to the offensive end, where they'll see Hudson, Dias, and Leon. Desmond, what are you thinking?
You know, that's a really efficient inning from SNU. That's really what you like to see. Graham pitching very well right now. And really like to see our bats get going again, as they have been in that first inning. And hopefully we can put one or two up again and hopefully tie this game up.
Yeah, you've got Hudson, Dias, and Leon coming up automatically. You've got three there. And all three of those guys have found the bat as of late. really well. They hit well against Northwestern, Oklahoma State. They've been hitting well the last few series as well. So you've got three guys coming up from the bottom part of your lineup that you feel like, really, if you needed them to, could be at the top as well.
Absolutely. Really, SMU's got a really balanced lineup in terms of a combination of power and contact. And that's what I really like about this team.
Yeah, absolutely. LeMay would be the fourth batter. He's at the nine spot in the lineup. Actually hit two home runs against Northwestern in the last game for Southern Nazarene. But they're going to come out still facing Williams. Kyle doesn't have a strikeout. There was a lot of contact made on him. Had a couple of hits given up, two singles. And Orman nearly able to get on base, as was Brinkmeyer. Brinkmeyer, controversial call over at first as they called him out. Could have gone either way. Southern Nazarene faithful obviously didn't like it, but as it stands, it's a 1-3 ball game. Southern Nazarene down by two to the Reddies out of Arkandelphia.
Not a bad number, 25. Correction number 22, Tay.
I wonder who came up with the name of Arkandelphia.
Well, it's in a, like, they call it the Delph. It's a weird story. I don't remember exactly what it, I do remember it's weird. They're the Badgers there, the high school, Arkandelphia High School, by the way. One-0 count, Williams against Hudson. Chase will foul that one off. Chase, a junior from Connor State. Hudson will take strike two. 1-2 count now against Chase Hudson, a 327 average for him this season. He's got 34 hits this year. Just one home run and six doubles. The 1-2 on the way. Off the mark. Now 2-2. Struck out 23 times as well this year. Now the 2-2 from Williams. Looking for the first strikeout of his day. Pitch comes in. Just off. So Hudson stays committed, has a full count, no outs, and a leadoff at bat of the second inning. Payoff pitch from Williams on the way. Hudson goes down swinging. First strikeout for Kyle Williams. With that, Max Dias comes to the plate. First K of the day on either side. Dias now against Williams. Takes ball inside. Max came in from New Orleans University, hometown of Porter, Texas. 1-0, swung on. Dias on the ground through the infield, gets it to left, and Max is standing on first. Max Dias reaches. That's his 30th hit of the year.
At number one, Alex Leon.
With that, Alex Leon will come to the plate.
You know, I just took a glance at this person's shirt in front of us. It said 6 + 4 + 3 = 2.
2 out, 6, 4, 3. Double play.
It's a great shirt.
It's nice. Sounded like you were confused for a second. I just want to make sure you got it. Yeah.
Grant, I played baseball for too long.
You did play for quite some time. The 0-1 now to Leon. They'll check first. Alex this season, a .261 average. He's got 12 hits on the year and 46 at-bats. He had four of those in a single game against Southeastern. Now the 0-1 to him. Swing, miss, strike two. 0-2 count. Tucker LeMay on deck for the Crimson Storm. He's a guy that's been hot as of late. Now the 0-2. Williams brings it in off the mark. 1-2 count. Now the 1-2 on the way. outside. Two balls, two strikes. Kyle Williams, the man on first, one out. Now the 2-2 out of the stretch. Williams loads, deals. Swung on, Leon on the ground towards third. Could be a double play. They're not going to get it. They do get the out at second, so Dias trot back to the dugout, but Alex stands on first.
Now to bat number two, Tucker LeMay.
Two outs, runner on first, and Tucker LeMay batting righty. LeMay, a 190 average this season, 15 hits for him on 79 at-bats, but there have been more lately than there were in the early parts of the year. 0-1 count. Williams delivers. 0-2. No balls, two strikes. Kyle, the man on first, out of the stretch. The two outs, pitch on the way. Outside, again, trying to get him reaching, Desmond. Now the 1-2, on the way, it's high, ball two. Two balls, two strikes. Tucker LeMay with a couple of outs on the board as well and a runner on first. Williams delivers. LeMay pops that one to the right side. Is it going to get out of play? It will. Falls in the bullpen of Henderson State. So Tucker stays alive. Williams, the 2-2. That's high for ball three. Full count out in front of us. Couple of outs, runner on first. It's a two-run lead for the Reddies. Tucker LeMay, man, don't throw a fastball inside on him. Payoff pitch on the way. LeMay will foul that one off straight back. It's going to hit the stands. Irvin was looking for it behind the dish, couldn't find it. Well, that's because it was nowhere near him. Tucker keeps on fighting. Looking to bring up Entwistle, who's on deck. Colby at the top of the lineup for Southern Nazarene. Payoff pitch, again, on the way. Runner goes, LeMay, going to have that one snatched out of the air by Argenbright over at shortstop. Nearly exactly the hit you needed if you were Tucker LeMay, but right there, Argenbright able to drift over and make the grab. Tough one at that. Desmond, what'd you see in that one?
You know, really a nice hit there from LeMay, but really just great play over there at shortstop. Not a lot you can do about that, but, you know, you're still looking good. You're still getting contact. It's really what you like to see, especially early on in these innings with a good pitcher up there like Williams.
And yeah,
I'm really confident in our abilities right now.
You know, I agree with you. And again, next time up for SNU, you'll be at the top of your lineup again. Really, just as Henderson State is right now, they've got Jones, Argenbright, and Farah coming to the plate against Levi Graham. Graham, really a solid first couple of innings. That last one was 1-2-3, a couple of ground outs and a pop out towards right field that was picked up by Leon. But here, he's got to face Jones, Archibald, and Farah again. He hit Jones on what would have been ball four anyway last time. And Archibald hitting into the double play. But after that, Henderson State was able to tack on three runs. Now Graham getting ready to work.
Yeah, when we talk about Graham, you know, we've mentioned it a couple of times. Normally you get about four or five really good innings from him. That's really what you'd like to see, maybe six.
Yeah.
And then hopefully get a closer in there that can put in some work and really give you a chance to succeed in this ball game.
Now Cal Jones at the plate. First pitch to him will be fouled off into the dugout of the Reddies. Jones, a freshman out of Texarkana, Texas. He's on the TX side of the line. That one's going to be dribbled down the third baseline. Foul ball, strike two. Cal this season's got an average of 274, and he started the year incredibly well. A couple of games up over 400. He had a 455 against Northwest Missouri. The 0-2, boy, nearly got him. Did he go? No. That curve from Levi Graham is just dirty. Jones has had 95 at-bats this year, 26 hits, only 23 strikeouts. That one's going to be popped over to Alex Leone. He scoops it, makes the grab, and will send it to first for out number one. Leone has been just a net over there at second base today. Now Arjun Bright to the plate for the Reddies. First pitch to Arjun Bright, called ball one. Caden, the senior, takes ball two. Native of Sulphur Springs, Texas. 354 average for him this season. Again, just 23 strikeouts as that one's fouled to the right side. Get this, 147 at-bats for him this year. 52 hits. That's an incredible mark. He's been walked 16 times. Now a 3-1 count. Four home runs for him this year, 12 doubles. Still has yet to hit his first triple, though. 3-1 on the way, swung on, hit high towards left field. Hudson underneath it. Chase makes the grab. That one was a little dangerous. Levi Graham, but he's put out. Now Farah to the plate.
Now batting number 10, Luke Farah.
Yeah, especially with the sun, really something you don't want to see as an outfielder is a ball hit high.
Luke Farah, the junior transfer out of Brookhaven College. Now the 1-0 on the way. He's going to tip that one for strike one. Now 1-1 count. Farah wants to lay it down. He's going to foul that one to hit his leg. Now 1-2 count against Farah. He's got a 207 average, and he's really been consistent with that all year. He's only broken 300 twice, once at Northeastern State and once versus Arkansas Tech. Those were some of the first few games of the year. 1-2, and they fouled off again. Now the 1-2, Levi Graham looking for the first strikeout of the day. Won't get it. That one's hit well to right field. Dias tracking Max along the wall, makes the grab. Another 1-2-3 inning for Levi Graham. Twice, back-to-back. How about it?
Yeah, that's exactly what you need.
Yeah, hey, get out the bats early as you can. Desmond, you got the top of your lineup coming up.
Really where you want to be at. Really efficient start of the lineup here for SNU. Really been hot, and I really expect them to continue their efficiency and probably put another run up on the board.
Colby Entwistle going to be the first man up for SNU. 257 average this year for him. 37 hits, 43 strikeouts. So he's swinging away, you best believe it. So far this year, he's got four home runs. He's a guy you like having at the plate. He's dangerous, 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 and aggressive too. Last time up, he hit a single. And just a couple pitches really set the tone for SNU of swinging away at any strike you give him.
You know, when we talk about Colby, we really talk about someone that's really clutch in a lot of situations. We've seen it a lot this season where we've really needed a hit, and he's come up big multiple times.
So Williams back out on the mound for SNU. Colby Entwistle, step out to the box. Blake Brinkmeyer's on deck for Southern Nazarene. Williams from the stretch, first pitch to Entwistle, outside, ball one. Now the 1-0 on the way. Entwistle lets it go by for strike one. The 1-1. Williams loads, deals. He'll bring it in outside edge for strike two. 1-2 count.
Williams really doing a good job of pinning this outside corner on Entwistle.
Now the 1-2 on the way. Entwistle gets a hack at it. Will pop it over to the right side in foul territory. It's going to drop in the bullpen of the Reddies. Remains a 1-2 count.
I'll tell you what, this catch is going to let you know if it's in or out.
Yeah, he will. He will.
Quite a vocal player. That's what you like to see, a catcher.
Especially behind the dish. To your point. Now the 1-2 to Entwistle. Again, oh, they'll get him looking on that one. So the second strikeout of the day for Kyle Williams. That time it was Colby who watched it go by. Now Blake Brinkmeyer, the freshman, hitting 325 this year to the plate. Brinkmeyer with 41 hits so far this year. Take a 1-0 count early. He grounded out towards second base his last time up. Now the 1-0 from Williams on the way. Blake checks. Did he go? I'll say he did. 1-1. Now the 1-1 on the way. Brinkmeyer sees ball two. Two balls, one strike. Williams loads, deals. There's ball three. Well, Kyle doesn't take much time to get ready to go, does he?
No, he does not. And as a pitcher, that's really what you want to do is get into a rhythm and keep that rhythm.
Yeah. The 3-1 on the way. Brinkmeyer will see ball four. So Blake takes the four-ball walk. It's 3-1 count that turns to 4-1. Based on balls, I should say, I guess. He stands on first. That's the point I'm trying
to make. He is on first.
Yes, Blake Brinkmeyer stands on first. What's next to the plate? Oh, my goodness. Fire me. First pitch to Hicks. Strike one.
I don't think those are grounds to fire you.
You may be right. You may be right. 261 average for Hicks this year.
I could be absolutely wrong.
You could. I mean, who's to say, really? Are you the man to stick it to? I don't know. 0-1, 0-2 now. Off the wave.
They could be on their way up here
they
as
could.
We speak.
Danny Thomason is out watching the game, so you know.
Shout out Danny.
Shout out. The 0-2 is going to be checked over to first. Weston Hicks looking for his 31st hit of the season. 0-2 count against him. One out on the board. Runner on first. That's Brinkmeyer. Martinez on deck. Now the 0-2. Williams delivers. The wave, the miss, strike three. It was an elevated fastball. No, Hicks likes those. So strike three turns into out number two.
Back to bat number 34, Jacob Martinez.
Now Jacob Martinez with a couple of outs. Runner on first will step up to the plate. He popped. Excuse me. Reached on a, oh my gosh. Hit a single. Got thrown out on a fielder's choice on his way to second. One of those days. 1-0 count to start us off. Pitch on the way. That will turn to 2-0 as it was off the mark. Two balls, no strikes. Brinkmeyer standing on first for SNU. Kyle on the stretch. Deals. Inside. So 3-0 count now against Martinez. Williams does get the strike call there. Martinez thought he might be walking to first. He will not. It's a 3-1 count. He'll at least have to see one more pitch. The 3-1 on the way. Outside ball four. So another walk in this inning puts another runner on for SNU. And Trey Orman now to the plate. Orman reached on a fielder's choice his last time up. Now two outs. Couple runners on. One in scoring position. First pitch to Orman. 1-0 count. Now the 1-0. Williams loads, deals, swung on Orman towards right field. That one's going to drop in foul territory. Orman making contact. You feel like he's just got to barrel one, and it's gone.
Yeah, especially with Williams really not hitting his spots right now. You really want to capitalize on something that he might throw more in the middle.
Base hit would be big here. Orman gets it on the ground, going to be scooped, and the play to second is there. The throw nearly took Farah off the base. Instead, he hangs on to it for out number three. So Orman again. Fielder's choice will be the third out. And that's going to bring out Levi Graham again to the mound. Graham off a back-to-back 1-2-3 innings. We'll see Rice, Holt, and Siegel. Let's take a break. Step away and be right back after this. Bring you back. Southern Nazarene now has left four runners on base. Henderson State, zero runners on base. But Henderson State leads it 3-1 here in the top of the fourth. And we said it in our pregame, Desmond, each game for Southern Nazarene is huge. You need to win out to have a chance at the postseason. You need some help as well.
Yeah, and it really starts with execution.
Yes.
I think that's something that we really need to focus on in this game, and unfortunately that hasn't been the case in these first couple innings, but I expect that to change here quite soon.
Rice at the plate. First pitch to him hit high towards right field. It's shallow and playable. It's in fair territory. Dias underneath it. Dias gets the out. So Rice flies out to right field. So one pitch, one out here in the fourth inning for Levi Graham. Continuing success. Now he's going to bring up Holt. Luke Holt hit a home run his last time up. It was a two-run shot. Now 1-0 count for him. Turns the 2-0.
Yeah, something I expect that Graham will focus on, especially at this at-bat, is to keep it low. Just to make sure that he can't loft it and do exactly what he did last time.
Now the 2-0. Graham delivers. Swung on the ground. Foul ball right side. Now the 2-1. Levi loads, deals. Oh, the wave got him reaching for it. He knew it immediately. Bad decision. 2-2. Graham showing off the stuff right now. Two balls, two strikes. Levi, pitch on the way. On the ground towards Leon. Leon, backhand, got it. And the throw on the money.
Like a net.
Alex gobbles it up, gets out number two. Now Siegel, the DH at the plate. He hit one towards center field that got caught by Martinez last time up. First pitch to Siegel. Outside, ball one. Now the 1-0 turns to 2-0. Graham looking for it here. The 2-0 on the way. That one's going to bounce for ball three. I think Entwistle took another one there.
I feel for him. That sucks.
Three balls, no strikes. Siegel. A walk for him would disrupt what could be the third straight three up, three down inning for Graham. The 3-0 turns to, they'll give him ball four. Graham didn't like that call, but they will send Siegel to first. Four pitches, four balls for Graham on that at bat. Now Irvin to the plate. He grounded out to LeMay last time up. First pitch, there's strike one. It's the one he wanted last at bat. Now the 0-1 from Graham. I kind of got the feeling you might check first on that one.
Just a little reset.
Just a little reset. Now the 0-1 from Levi. Breaking ball. Beautiful pitch. Dude, that curve is just so good. I love a good curveball. I'm sorry. Just hit him with it. It's my favorite pitch. The 0-2, now let's send it to first again. Graham disrupting the rhythm of Irvin, the catcher. 0-2 count. Now the 0-2 on the way outside. Good block by Entwistle. Runner going to second. The throw will almost reach center field. LeMay able to back it up. Entwistle had a shot at it. Just to the right of Leon. Now 1-2 count. Runner on second. Two outs on the board. Bit of a hectic play there. Now the 1-2. Levi loads, delivers. 2-2. Graham, the 2-2 on the way, got him swinging. Levi Graham picks up the first strikeout of the contest for him in the top of the fourth. That will be out number three, so it's not three up, three down, but it is four batters faced and no one able to get around to home. Levi Graham absolutely dealing right now. Due up for Southern Nazarene is Hudson, Diaz, and Leon, but we'll take a break before then and be right back after this.
Renew is the University Counseling Center. We are located at 6710 Northwest 43rd Street, just north of the Webster Commons. Renew offers a variety of services, including individual counseling, couples counseling, and psychoeducational workshops. The first five sessions for students are free, and students will never pay more than $10 per session. Faculty counseling is just $40 per session. Renew is open Monday through Thursday from 9 a.m. to 8 p.m. and Fridays from 11 a.m. until 6 p.m. For more information, visit renew.snu.edu or email renew@mail.snu.edu.
We bring you back into Phelan Field. Kyle Williams remains on the bump. He's faced 12 batters so far today and allowed three hits, but only one run from Southern Nazarene. He's going to face Chase Hudson, Max Dias, and Alex Leon. I tell you what, Alex has been an animal in the field so far today. That backhand play to get out number two was fantastic.
That's a hard play to make. Backhands are really...
Boy, he looked like Robert Moore out there at second base. Any Arkansas Razorback fans? Maybe Kansas City Royal fans?
I'm a Cardinals fan.
First pitch. Now to Hudson. On the way, that one's inside. 1-0 count.
Grant, who's your favorite MLB player of all time?
Albert Pujols.
You know what the weird part is?
What?
That's exactly who I was going to say.
Really?
Yes. I grew up watching him. Definitely my favorite player to watch. Him, Yachty,
okay.
Adam Wainwright, David Fries.
Now the 2-0 to Hudson on the way. Chase will watch you go by for strike one. Two balls, one strike. Williams. First at bat of the bottom of the fourth. You feel like SNU is just moments away from being able to finally break through. Hudson on the ground towards first, hard hit ball. Boy, won't be able to reach first, but making the grab was Rice, who kind of stumbled back from the power. He's able to toss it over to Williams and get out number one. Now Max Dias to the plate for SNU. He did hit a single his last time up. Dias makes contact towards center field. Could be caught, looks like it should be, and it's dropped! Max Dias will reach second base. Moore was back there, poised to make the grab, but it travels just a little bit further than he would have liked. I think the Oklahoma wind got to him there. And Chance Bufford now to the plate in place of Leon. So officially, Diaz reaches on error and advances to second. On the first pitch to Bufford, off the mark. Chance Bufford, a senior out of Norman, Oklahoma. Went to Norman North High School. Now in what? His final conference series at home here at Phelan Field. 2-1 count against him. 239 average for Chance this year. 11 hits so far this season. The 2-1 with one out, runner on second. Williams delivers. There's strike two. Two balls, two strikes. Williams from the stretch brings it in. Buffer gets a hold of that one towards right field. Will it drop? It will not. Tough grab is made, but Diaz is going to stand up on third. Two outs now. This Buffer flew out to right field.
Great job by Buffer right there, getting it out to right field, yeah, making sure that his runner can get to third.
So LeMay at the plate with Diaz on third. A base hit scores and cuts the lead to one. First pitch to Tucker on the way. LeMay will fly that one straight back. Should be caught behind the plate. It is. There's out number three as Irvin falls down making the grab. Again, just unfortunate for SMU. You feel like you're right there, ready to get something going, and you just can't do it. Now five runners left on base for SMU in this one. We'll get ready for the top of the fifth, and we'll be right back after this. Desmond feels like he's TNT, and Levi Graham may be a little bit more explosive than Desmond Williams on the mound up there. Boy, Levi getting into his fifth inning in this start has been throwing an absolute gem, especially here as of late. As it stands right now, today he's thrown a 6.75 ERA, but really not telling of the day he's had. The first inning put up three, really not his fault as an error came in. That extended the inning just enough. He's going to come up and face Thomas, Moore, and Jones. That's 8, 9, and 1. First pitch to Thomas outside, ball one. Now the 1-0 swung on, hit hard, but foul to the left side. It was a line drive that would have been a tough one to get to. Hudson over in left field might have been a triple even the way that was hit. 1-1 count. Graham delivers. There's strike two. Levi taking his time. Now the 1-2 on the way. That one swung on, scooped by LeMay. Tucker takes his time, delivers. There's out number one. Tucker LeMay doing exactly what you want your shortstop to do. Beautiful play by him. No longer Tucker LeMay, it looks like. Yes, it is.
Yes, it is, but a couple changes.
Yeah, we do some changes. Well, you remember, so Chance Bufford over at third, and you've got Brinkmeyer on second. Alex Leone was replaced by Bufford.
Right, right.
So, yes, there you go. 1-0 count now against Moore. Now the pitch on the way. There's 1-1.
Yeah, it was just really unfortunate. Leone was playing really well in the field.
Oh, yeah, incredibly
but just,
well.
The batting was something that they really need right now. And
just a situation
right,
thing, really.
Right.
Yeah. 1-2 count from Graham. Pitch on the way, swung on. That's going to be tipped back. Looks like Gabe Sanchez warming up in the bullpen for SNU. Boy, he dealt his last time, replacing Graham as well. Now 1-2 count, one out, no one on. Pitch on the way. Graham will bounce that one. He pulled it. Two balls, two strikes. Nate Moore, who popped up to Leon over at second. Now it would be Brinkmeyer. The 2-2 swung on, hit well towards left field. This ball might get down. No! A sliding grab by Hudson. They'll say he dropped it. It's going to be on the ground, nearly making the tag was Brinkmeyer. But with that, Moore will reach second. Looked like it would have been a good play by Hudson, but kind of got his foot caught in the grass. Fortunately, he didn't hurt himself on that one. So runner now on second, one out. We'll have a conversation. This might be the end of the day for Levi Graham. Gabe Sanchez set to come on out to the bump. 6.49 ERA for him so far this season. They will call it for Levi Graham. A good day for him. Incredible start, exactly what SNU needed. 6.23 ERA is not telling of the way this one went for Graham. He had back-to-back 1-2-3 innings, followed by a four batters faced inning. Now he's already put one out on the board for Sanchez. And again, what we talked about in the first inning, not Graham's fault that there's a runner on.
Absolutely, just kind of an unfortunate situation with a couple of errors and then just kind of left one hanging and they took it the distance.
Now on the mound for Southern Missouri, number 16, Gabriel Sanchez.
So Gabe Sanchez will step in and get ready to face the top of the lineup for Henderson State. Cal Jones set to come up, and Caden Arbright, rather Arjun Bright, on deck. Standing on second will be Nate Moore, the center fielder. Boy, Desmond, been a tight one here, hasn't it?
It has been. It's been a great game, and you love to see that. I don't really like to see blowouts. Sometimes it just gets boring as a spectator.
It can be exciting.
It can be. But at the same time, you really want to see some action on both sides, and that's what we're getting right now.
I think both sides really understand the weight of each of these games. Henderson State sitting at eighth in conference play, tied up with 6-7 as well at 13 wins. But Swasu could pull something off. And again, if Swasu's able to pull off jumping into the postseason against the teams they're facing, boy, they're dangerous. It's Northwestern, Arkansas Monticello, and Southern Arkansas, 1-3-4 in conference play. Two of the Bulldogs are facing off against to finish their season, but Henderson State doesn't want to be the team to drop out and potentially be replaced by either Swasu or Southern Nazarene. So runner on second, one out on the board. Gabe Sanchez to the mound. A 6.49 ERA for him this season. That one going to be rolled down the third baseline. Buffer, bare hand, holds on to it. Runners on the corners. A beautiful bunt by Jones.
And that's a little what looks like a drag bunt almost.
Yeah.
Really getting out there late and Bufford really had no time to react to that. Just great execution right there from Cal Jones.
Sanchez gets strike one against Arjun Bright. Hayden's made some plays over shortstop today that have been pretty fun to watch. Runner's going to go to second. They do make the throw. It's going to get into center field. One more is going to score for Henderson State. So the Reddies put one on and advance a runner to third. The throw from Entwistle really was where it needed to be. But it looked like Brinkmeyer ran into the runner. So the ball got by him. And now Henderson State leads it by three runs. That ball hit high towards left field. It's shallow and playable. Hudson's gonna have to let it bounce. It's gonna be a double. No, send him back to first. What a strange turn of events right there. Another one plates for Henderson State, makes it 5-1. Off the RBI single from Farah. Excuse me, from Argenbright. Now Farah to the plate. Farah sends that one into the left field. Going to get down. Brought in by Hudson. Now runners on first and second.
Henderson really putting the bat on the ball right now.
Yeah, five hits now for them. Four of them in this inning. Now the first pitch to Rice. Let me call ball. Luke Rice. Kind of a scary bat at the plate. I'll be careful around his strike zone. The 1-0. The wave. They'll get the strike call off the swing. So 0-2 count against Luke Rice. One out on the board. Runners on first and second. Sanchez. He'll load. Deliver. Swing. Miss. Strike three. So Gabe Sanchez gets his first strikeout of the day. And with that, they'll bring up Holt. Sanchez now 23 strikeouts this season. Holt checks, takes strike one. No balls, one strike. Gabe Sanchez. Two outs. He's going to send it back to second. Got him! Wow. Argenbright took off. LeMay places the tag. So Holt will get another chance at the plate next time up for him in the sixth. For SNU, they're going to bring up Entwistle, Brinkmeyer, and Hicks. Trailing by four. Desmond, what are you thinking?
Sanchez put that ball right on the money.
Yes, he did.
You couldn't have put that in a better spot to get that out. And you know, he gave a couple runs, but at the same time, you're still in a great position to make a comeback here. And hopefully we get these bats rolling yet again, like we saw in the first inning, and put a couple runs up right now.
Now one earned run given up for Sanchez. Also got a strikeout, however, no walks, three hits. So coming in, facing Kyle Williams in the fifth inning. You feel like, man, we keep saying this. I feel like we've said this about every single team that we face here at Field. You feel like Southern Nazarene is just one or two moments away from absolutely breaking the pitching. But so far today, it's been phenomenal for Williams. ERA of 2.25 so far. He's got three strikeouts, two walks, only allowing three hits to this point. He's also had some good help from his field. So Colby Entwistle to the plate. He went down to look in his last time up. Didn't like the strike three call. He got a single back in the first.
Back to break, Colby Entwistle.
Colby looking to set the tone in the bottom of the fifth. First pitch, Stant whistle. He'll let it go by for ball one. Now the 1-0. Williams delivers off the mark, ball two. A 2-0 on the way. Williams will get strike one on Entwistle. Now two balls, one strike in the first at bat of the bottom of the fifth. Southern Nazarene trailing by four runs against the number eight team in conference. A 2-1 away for strike two. Now the 2-2. Kyle on the stretch, loads, delivers. Swung on, Entwistle, foul ball right side. Williams, another 2-2. Entwistle sees ball three. It was high.
Good discipline right there.
Full count, no outs. Williams with the payoff pitch. That's ball four. Colby Entwistle walks to first after a tough at bat. Now Brinkmeyer to the plate.
It's something that I failed to mention earlier is that the wind has shifted more to center field.
Yes.
Instead of left.
So the third walk of the day for Williams, he's going to get a talking to. As he gets ready to face Blake Brinkmeyer. Blake grounded out to second base in the first, then got walked back in the second. That was actually the first walk given up by Kyle Williams. Excuse me, walked in the third.
You know, Blake Brinkmeyer, someone that I really like to talk to. He's very knowledgeable in baseball, really humble guy.
Yeah.
Someone that you'd really like to get to know. And he's a great baseball player as well.
Now Williams against Brinkmeyer. First pitch to Blake off the mark, ball one. No outs on the board, runner on first. Exactly where Brinkmeyer wants to be. The 1-0. Pitch on the way. Blake sees ball two. Now the 2-0. Williams delivers strike one. Brought the heat. Two balls, one strike. Kyle Williams to Brinkmeyer. Pitch on the way. Off the mark. That one's going to get by. And Entwistle can stand up safely on second. Three balls, one strike. Now popped out of the glove that time of Irvin behind the dish. He had to chase it down, but couldn't get there in time to make the throw to second. Blake Brinkmeyer. Wow, Blake Brinkmeyer now a 3-1 count. Fire foul ball question mark. It's going to be out of play in the SNU dugout. Oh my goodness. What a play that time by Thomas. He ran over and reached into the SNU dugout, made the grab.
Extremely impressive play.
No defense played by SNU on that one. None. So one out now on the board. And again, Williams getting a little help from his field. Now Hicks at the plate will foul the first one off. Getting Brinkmeyer on would have been huge. One out, the 0-1 on the way. Boy, outside edge, 0-2. No balls, two strikes, one out on the board, runner on second. Williams delivers, swung on, Hicks. Gonna be in play over to third base. Thomas making the throw, routine for out number two. And suddenly, Henderson State feeling comfortable with this inning. Jacob Martinez to the plate. Little bat lefty. And the wind blowing straight out. First pitch to Martinez. Yeah, he nods his head, he knew it. You know if Jacob Martinez agrees with the call, not because he's going to be out loud about it, but he'll just shake his head yes or no. 0-1 count. Pitch on the way. Jacob lets it go by for strike two.
And there we got a little, I don't know about that, nod.
No balls, two strikes, couple of outs. Runner on second, that's Entwistle. 0-2, the wave, the miss, strike three, swing it. So Williams gets out of the inning. Jacob Martinez, the last batter faced. Orman, Hudson, and Dias will be the next up for Southern Nazarene. On the other side, Holt, Siegel, and Irvin do up. We'll take a break, step away, and be right back after this. You're watching SMU Baseball on the Call Sports Network.
My favorite things about SNU was the relationships I was able to have with people, with professors, with friends.
One thing that was purposely different about SNU was the integration of faith into the academics. I feel like I learned so much from that that helped prepare me for life after college, to be a husband and someday to be a father. It was a really, really transformational time in my life.
My degree could have come from anywhere, but my relationships with people, I know I would not have gotten anywhere else. Go to snu.edu to apply or to schedule a visit.
Oh, you bring you back into Phelan Field. It's the top of the six, Southern Nazarene. Still trailing by four. I can have Gabe Sanchez back out on the mound. Holt will be the first one up against Sanchez. Then Siegel and Irvin will follow him. Gabe last time allowed a single earned run as well as three hits, but he also got a strikeout and was able to get SMU back out of the inning. It's a 5-1 ball game. So Luke Holt at the plate. First pitch to him, strike one. Luke grounded out to second in the fourth. But also hit a two-run home run in the first. 0-1 on the way, hit high towards center field. This one playable, Martinez underneath it. Jacob. Drifting makes the catch. Now Siegel to the plate for Henderson State.
Number 35, Mitch Siegel.
Siegel, the DH, got walked his last time up and flew out to center field in the first. Now the 1-0 from Sanchez, delivered high for ball two against Siegel. Mitchell Siegel, well, it looked like home plate umpire is getting ready to call a strike and decides not to. 3-0 count. The pitch on the way, ball four, and Siegel will walk to first. So base on balls for Mitchell Siegel, his second straight time getting walked. Now Irvin comes to the plate. Last time up for Landon was a strikeout swinging. He grounded out to third, back in the second. Pitch on the way, the swing is going through and the tag not there as Brinkmeyer couldn't hold on to it. It bounced out of his glove. Siegel steals second.
Yeah, right there we see a classic hit and run. Obviously, he did not want to swing at that, but because of the circumstances, he absolutely had to.
1-1 count. Sanchez delivers, breaking ball outside. 2-1. Now Gabe. From the stretch with a runner on second and one out. Brings it in, foul ball. Two balls, two strikes. Gunnar Phillips just made a nice grab at the dugout. Sanchez, the 2-2. Another foul tip. Another 2-2 pitch on the way. High, ball three. The wind now ripping straight out to center field. Full count. Sanchez, the payoff pitch on the way. Breaking ball, swung on, foul ball. Boy, Landon Irvin battling in this at bat. Three foul balls now.
Yeah, great fire right here. If you're SNU, you really need to strike out just to give yourself some breathing room.
Payoff pitch again, fouled off. Now four foul balls this at bat.
Irvin's going to make him earn it.
Sanchez. Another payoff pitch on the way. Gabe loads, delivers, swung on again. This one in play towards right field. Underneath it is Hicks. Weston makes the grab. Not often an at-bat that long goes your way as a pitcher. That time it does.
Yeah, and just like I said, now we got a little breathing room. Runner on second, two outs. Feeling pretty good right now.
Yeah, and Dylan Thomas to the plate for Henderson. First pitch to him. Foul tip straight back. No balls, one strike. Runner on second. That's Siegel. Sanchez looking to get Siegel. Sleeping, couldn't do it. Now the 0-1 from Gabe. Swung on, foul ball. 0-2. No balls, two strikes. Couple of outs, runner on second. Gabe Sanchez delivers, breaking ball up the middle. Brinkmeyer nearly made a beautiful grab. It's going to bounce off his glove. Siegel from second will score. And so Thomas hits it hard enough to be able to reach first and score one as well.
Really just an unfortunate play there. Brinkmeyer rolling towards first and then immediately had to track back and try and get it just off the tip of his glove.
Now a 6-1 ball game. Henderson State in control. First pitch to Moore off the mark, 1-0. Now the 1-0 from Sanchez off the mark, 2-0. Two balls, no strikes. Gabe loads, delivers, got it, strike one. Now the 2-1, Sanchez delivers, breaking ball, strike two. 2-2 count now against Moore as Nate has a runner on first and a couple of outs. Sanchez to get out of the sixth. Swung on, that one dropped over to Brinkmeyer. He's gonna scoop it up, make the throw. Well, with that, you finally get your third out, Desmond. Now you're headed to the offensive side, and again, you've been poking and prodding, but nothing has gone through for you if you're SNU.
Yeah, last inning looked really promising after a Colby Entwistle walk, but just a couple of unfortunate outs, and Henderson State has been really efficient out in the field. So right now you're really hoping just to get those balls in the gaps. Get you a couple right here. You really need it.
Yeah, you really need crooked numbers right now as well. Late in this one, and we talked about it. We've brought it up a few times now. Basically, you need to win out if you're SNU, and that starts with winning your home games against, rankings-wise, the lightest opponent you have left on the season. Given everybody that you're facing the rest of the year, as it stands right now, has 13 wins exactly. But you got to win this one.
Absolutely, especially at home. You really need to get this sweep just to keep yourself in the conversation. And right now, if you're SNU, you got to have that mentality of, okay, we really need to get these runs. We really need to get this game, get into the doubleheader tomorrow, and get those.
Yeah. Well, man, the tough part is you're 9-9 at home this season. That's an all right mark. But that means you're 2-18 at away games. That's what hurts you. And that's why you have to win your home games. To have a chance.
Absolutely.
First pitch to Trey Orman. It's going to be a 1-0 count. It's going to be Orman, Hudson, and Dias. The next three up for SNU. Now Warman on the ground towards second. Tough hop picked up well. And the throw is on the money as Farah makes the play. One out now.
Chase Hudson.
Chase Hudson to the plate for SNU. Max Dias on deck. Pitch on the way. Chase takes strike one. No balls, one strike. Outside. Now the 1-1 on the way towards Hudson. Chase will check. Did he go? He did not. 2-1. Now the 2-1 from Williams. Outside. I feel like in this sixth inning, Williams likely has a tighter leash. He's already had one mound visit. He's up over 70 pitches now. The 3-1 will turn to ball four. So Hudson walks to first. Now Dias to the plate.
Doesn't look like we're going to get a mound visit. Yeah, something I kind of expected.
Skipper Cody Hooten holding off for at least one more at bat. Dias will take strike one. For SNU, you're feeling like, boy, the quicker you can get Williams out of the game, the better.
Absolutely. He's been really efficient.
Yeah, 1.69 ERA to this point. Four walks and four strikeouts. Really exactly what we said he was likely going to do coming into this one. He's going to walk you, but he's also going to strike you out and keep you from reaching base.
Right, and we've seen it a lot with him pinpointing the outside edges and just trying to get guys to chase, and it's been pretty successful so far.
Now the 0-2 towards Dias is high. One ball now.
And he put a little oomph into that one.
Yeah. Now the 1-2 on the way. Dias on the ground towards shortstop, backhanded grab, the throw, then the turn won't be there. So out number two comes by. It's Hudson's thrown out at second. Max Dias able to reach first.
Really impressive play over there by Arden Bright. Getting that out at second.
Yeah, Arden Bright's been incredible over a shortstop.
This whole defense has just been really efficient.
Yes. Chance Buffer now to the plate. First pitch by him. Swung on towards center field. Will it drop? It will. It will drop, and Dias will hold up on third. Chance Buffer puts runners on the corners. A single for Buffer. Now Tucker LeMay to the plate with two outs and two on. Base hit puts one on the board for you. Entwistle on deck.
Absolutely need this right here.
First pitch to LeMay. Strike one.
It was close.
Now the 0-1. Swung on, LeMay on the ground towards second, tough hop, man, but it's gobbled up. And the throw is there. The hop did all it could to disrupt that play for Farah over on second, but he recovers, makes a play for out number three. And again, SNU leaving runners on base. Eight now have been left on. Desmond, that's been the story of the day.
It really has. I was about to say that, really. Just unable to execute in just some unfortunate situations. Just having fall to SNU's side. Well, there's good news and bad news.
Bad news is you've left eight runners on.
Yes.
Good news is still got two more innings to do what you do best.
Yeah, top of the seventh on the way. And SNU, boy, they'll bring Gabe Sanchez back out, and I tell you what, just got to keep dealing.
Absolutely.
You can only do so much on the defensive side, and you have given up six runs as a team, but boy, it's really the offense just hasn't gotten it to go. That's been the story, like we said.
It really has.
Due up for Henderson State, it's going to be Jones, Argent, Bright, and Farrah. It's the 1, 2, and 3 of the lineup for the Reddies. And if you're Henderson State, if you can win this one, then you're feeling real confident about holding on to your spot in the GAC tournament, whether that means holding on to number 8 or moving up even to 6, potentially. The first pitch to Jones will be a strike. Now the 0-1. Jones lays it down third baseline, nearly a beautiful, perfect punt, but it's going to go foul. Boy, small ball, Henderson State really good at it.
Really, and something I've noticed is that whenever they get two outs, the first thing they do is they show bunt.
Yeah.
Just kind of trying to throw that pitcher off, and it's really worked so far in this game.
The 0-2 swung on will go foul to the right side. Now Cal Jones, an 0-2 count. Take ball one. Little sporadic throw there from Sanchez. Now the 1-2. Swung on again, foul ball. Gains a 1-2 count.
Something else you'll notice with Henderson State's hitting is that they're very efficient, they're very disciplined, and they'll fight off anything that's close.
Yes. 1-2, that one. Going to go foul to the left side again.
Speaking of it.
One ball, two strikes. Sanchez on the bump, working against Jones. The 1-2 from Gabe.
Again.
Wouldn't you guess it? We may never get out of here.
We're going to be stuck here forever.
Again, the 1-2 from Sanchez.
We're going to run out of baseballs.
Breaking ball just off. Now the 2-2. Gabe delivers. That one swung on, hit well towards right field, gets down. Diaz will scoop it. And it'll be a single for Cal Jones. Good hitting that time from Cal.
Yeah, Cal, only a freshman, but really showing a lot of discipline up there, looking like a veteran.
Now Caden Argenbright, batting lefty. Sanchez checks first. Count against Caden, shortstop. Well, Sanchez nearly got that ball back to first in perfect time. As Jones had started to take his jump towards second.
A lot of resets.
Now the 1-0. Gabe steps onto the rubber. Sanchez delivers strike one. There you go. Now the 1-1 on the way off the mark. Sanchez brings in the 2-1. That one going to get over LeMay and into center field. A blooper will turn into a single, which puts Jones on second and Argenbright on first. Back-to-back singles for the Reddies. Still no outs on the board for SNU. Now Farah. Well, Farah thought about laying it down. Quickly changed his mind as that one headed to his head. One ball, no strikes. That one laid down by Farah, and again, the bunt falls in the perfect spot, and they load the bases. No outs, bases juiced, cleanup hitter, Luke Rice at the plate.
Such an efficient team, able to execute whenever they need it.
Rice will take strike one. All GAC honorable mention a season ago. That one's hit high to the left side, will go foul and make it 0-2. Hasn't hit a single home run this season, by the way. Only three doubles. Does have a triple as well. Now the 0-2 from Sanchez. Swung on, up the middle, LeMay scoops it, Tucker touches second, and will hold on to it. So one out now on the board. Henderson State puts another run on. Makes it 7-1.
Probably a good decision there by LeMay, making sure that if there's a ball that gets away from him, that
yeah,
there's not an extra score.
Now the first pitch to Louis Holt, called ball one. Louis wants to bunt. That one will drop straight down and be a foul ball.
A little squeeze bunt action, maybe? I can't say for sure. I'm not sure I would go for that in this situation, especially being up 7-1. Especially when you've been really efficient hitting-wise.
The thing is, you know, Southern Nazarene's done it to so many teams where you feel like they're out of it, and then all of a sudden they're putting up 8 runs. We've got a discussion now between Grant Ledbetter, the home plate umpire. Boy, the wind is too much. We can't tell what is going on.
No, I kind of have a feeling that it has something to do with ant whistle behind the dish. Maybe not agreeing with some of the calls.
Both sides will part ways, and we'll get action back underway. 1-1 count, Sanchez working against Louis Holt, the left fielder. Sanchez loads, delivers, breaking ball off the mark. Here we go. Now the 2-1. Bunt down the third baseline goes foul. Remains a 2-2 count. Now Sanchez with runners on the corners and one out. 6-run deficit for Southern Nazarene. Oh, and Sanchez has caught Rice in a pickle. Now throw it home. Not there in time. Oh, no. It's going to get by Entwistle. Bounced off his foot. So not only does Henderson State score one, the runner that could have been an easy out for SNU will advance a second. Still just one out. Now an 8-1 ball game. A 2-2 count for Louis Holt. The pitch will bounce, make it a full count. Now the payoff from Sanchez, swung on high and hard towards center field. Martinez under it. Jacob will trot up, send it in. Not going to be good enough to make the throw to third, but you do get out number two. With that, Rice now standing on third. Holt the second out, and Siegel to the plate.
You know, looks like they were a little questionable on if Rice might have left early. They checked in, and of course he was indeed in time.
So the wave brings around strike one from Siegel. Now the 0-1 on the way again. We'll turn to 0-2. Kind of sounded like the backswing hit Entwistle's helmet, didn't it?
I think it did.
0-2 count. Sanchez delivers. Foul ball. Looked like Gabe wanted to blow that one by Siegel. Mitch not having it. Now a pitch on the way. The 0-2. Oh. Gunnar Phillips just ate that one.
Took
it back
like a champ. Not even phased.
Yeah, Gunnar Phillips acting like it didn't touch him. I know it hurt.
He's not going to let you know that.
He said, hey, Gabe, get him out. That's what he just said. That's hilarious. The 1-2. Now Siegel. With a 1-2 count against him. Sanchez brings in the pitch, another foul ball. You know, in softball, you get the wall or the net that kind of comes around and covers the front of your dugout. Baseball, you don't have that.
No, and I've always thought that was pretty interesting.
Guess they just don't care about baseball players as much.
Probably not.
Now 1-2, Sanchez loads, deals. Another foul ball. Just can't seem to get Mitchell out. Sanchez does have one strikeout today. Second one will be much appreciated, and he got it. Off speed, froze him. How about that pitch?
Amazing. Exactly what you need, especially in that situation. Threw a lot of fastballs at him. Got him with the off speed. And now you just need your offense to work.
Well, we'll take a break, step away, and be right back after this. You're watching SNU Baseball on the Call Sports Network. We'll be right back. Well, you bring you back into the action as there's a new face on the mound, which is exactly what you want to hear if you're Southern Nazarene. It's Baylor Brumley, the native of Smackover, Arkansas. Smackover High School.
What a name for a town.
Oh, incredible. Arkansas's got some good names, let me tell you. 146 ERA for Brumley. He's been solid arm for Henderson State, to say the least. 12 and one-third innings pitched. Only allowed 9 hits and 2 earned runs in 12 innings. 12 and one-third. No home runs have been hit off of him this season. Brumley, a junior, redshirt junior, out of Smackover, standing 6'3". Well, Desmond, you're going to test him with the top of your lineup. It's Entwistle, Brinkmeyer, and Hicks.
Yeah, you got a really efficient pitcher, but at the same time, you got a really efficient offense, especially this start of the lineup.
Well, not today.
Yeah, not today, though.
Brumley, 7 strikeouts this season, 6 walks. Very similar style to what we just saw with Williams. First pitch, called 0-1 now. Brumley delivers, Entwistle. Not able to barrel that one. Oliver Wilson with a tough grab in the dugout. 0-2 count. No balls, 2 strikes. Pitch on the way. Entwistle towards left field. Should be caught. No. He'll let it bounce. Safe play made out in left field by Holt. That puts Entwistle on first. Leadoff single here in the 7th. Now Blake Brinkmeyer to the plate. Brinkmeyer popped it over to the SNU dugout his last time up, but it was caught by Thomas, who reached through the faces of Southern Nazarene. Brinkmeyer threatens to lay it down. That'll be ball 1. See Henderson State, how they react to that. Thomas over on third just now put his glove on. Now the 1-0 outside.
I feel like you can get away with that in the outfield. Not so much at third.
Yeah, that's a tough.
Not so much at the
if you have any
corner.
Trouble at all putting that glove on, it's over. The 2-0.
At that point, do you just throw your glove at the ball?
Brinkmeyer again. Acts like he's going to lay it down. Pulls back for ball 3. Thomas was ready for it. He started sprinting in quickly on that pitch. Now the 3-0 turns to 3-1. Three balls, 1 strike. Brumley against Brinkmeyer. Deals. There's strike 2. Late call. Full count now for the redshirt junior against Brinkmeyer. Brumley, payoff pitch. That's off the mark for ball 4. So runners on first and second, no outs. Off the single and then a walk from Brumley. And Weston Hicks to the plate. Jacob Martinez on deck. First pitch, called strike 1. No balls, 1 strike. Brumley loads, deals. Weston, watch strike 2, outer edge. Now the 0-2.
pretty good opportunity here for SNU. Just really need to execute these next at-bats, really get some runs on the board.
Hicks gets a hold of that one towards left field. Boy, it dives in left field to get down. Entwistle puts his head down and gets home. So an RBI single from Hicks puts Brinkmeyer on second and scores Entwistle. Now Jacob Martinez to the plate. SU now trailing by six.
Hey, you take what you can get.
Yeah. We'll get a meeting on the mound. No pitching change to be made. We'll still see Brumley. No outs on the board. Runners on first and second. Jacob Martinez on deck. Well, you feel something in the air, don't you, Desmond?
I do indeed. SNU, been in this situation a lot where people kind of leave them out and then they just get back in it somehow, some way.
First pitch to Martinez off the mark. Next 1-0 count. Brumley on the mound again from Smackover High School. Get this, home of the Battling Buckaroos out in Hot Springs National Park. Interesting. The 1-0, Martinez on the ground towards first. What a snatch by Rice to get the first out. Runners advance, but he had no business making that play. Oh my goodness.
Now by number 28, Trey Orman.
That was an incredible grab.
That was a great play. Took a bad hop, and he's able to read that. Something that I would say not a lot of people are able to do.
Yeah. Now Trey Orman to the plate. One out, runners on second and third. Trailing by six.
Okay, I want to go back to the Battling Buckaroos.
Battling Buckaroos. That's hilarious.
Is that better than the Thunder Ducks?
Yes, I think so. Because the logo looks like an exact outline of Northwestern Oklahoma State. 1-0 turns to 2-0. It's just slanted a little bit. That's exactly what it is. That's funny. Orman towards left field. This one should be caught, and it is. But that will allow Brinkmeyer to reach home. So two outs, sack fly from Trey. We'll bring in Blake Brinkmeyer, but hold Hicks on second.
Now Chase Hudson
to the plate. Two outs on the board, runner on second. Five run ball game. Chase Hudson batting lefty with Max Dias on deck. Hudson got walked his last time up. Brumley delivers. Hudson on the ground towards first. And again, not getting through. Rice covers it. This infield for Henderson State, outstanding. Wouldn't you say?
I would absolutely say that. We've been talking about it a lot. A couple of really good plays all around. And just, you know, there's not a lot to say about it, really.
Well, here's the good thing. You cut it down a little bit if you're SNU. Now five-run difference. Top of the eighth, still some time. Hey, we're going to take a break. Be right back after this. You're watching SNU Baseball on the Call Sports Network.
Character, culture, and Christ have been the motto for Southern Nazarene University for many, many years. When I came as president, I was really curious about those words and really curious to dig into the archives. In fact, a conversation on campus one day with a visitor to our campus who asked that same question, what does character, culture, and Christ mean today? These days, I like to talk about refining character. I think that we're all in process, and in those collegiate years, those years of a university experience, there's a great opportunity to refine character.
Well, we bring you back in. We've got Gabe Sanchez on the bump for Southern Nazarene. And he's going to have to come out and face Irvin, Thomas, and more. Last inning saw SNU gain some ground on Henderson State in the bottom half, but that was after giving up three runs in the top. Now Landon Irvin at the plate facing Sanchez. It's 7-8-9 for Henderson State. One oh turns to 2-0.
Yeah, like you said, still a lot of work to be done for SNU, and it all starts on the defensive side, making sure that this Henderson State team doesn't get hot yet again, really shutting them down and getting it back to those bats that are progressively getting hotter.
Three balls, no strikes. Sanchez delivers breaking ball, ball four. Just outside again, saw it earlier too, that alley. You know, you get a 17-inch plate, and that was probably an 18, 19-inch pitch.
I agree.
Well, after the walk, that'll bring Thomas to the plate. Dylan, number 8 batter in the lineup. First pitch hit high towards center field. Martinez looking for it in the sun. Will make the catch and send it in, holding Irvin on first. But that's not an easy catch out in center field, staring directly into the sun. It may be 92 million miles away, but it is still very bright. Now Nate Moore, the 9-hole batter who's been out in center field, will step up. Sanchez checks first. First pitch to Nate Moore is a ball, so 1-0 count. Will be 1-1 if that one's called strike. That ball ripped towards left center field. It's going to get down, be at least a single. Moore will turn around, hit second. That ball bounces off of Bufford. Luckily, it does go straight to Weston Hicks. Could have been some danger for SNU as that one hit the leg of Chance Bufford and shot to the right. But a double as it stands, which will advance Irvin to third. And with that, Gal Jones to the plate. One out on the board. Jones hits that one high towards right field. That one's in fair territory. Underneath it, and it's going to be dropped by Brinkmeyer. Blake couldn't hold on to it. And so Irvin gets home. Moore gets to third, and Jones gets to second.
Irvin, number 6, Caden Ogerblake.
Now a 9-3 ball game. Henderson State leading. One out. Arjun Bright at the plate. Caden fouls the first one off to the left side. Now the 0-1 on the way. Arjun Bright gets a hold of that one towards right field. Caden will be out. What a grab, a leaping one by Dias to get out number two. Now the throw down to home. Around the tag is Cal Jones. The throw was in time and in the right spot, but Jones just got around the glove of Entwistle.
Extremely smooth slide right there.
So two outs, but two runs score for Henderson State. Now 11-3 is the score. Luke Farah at the plate. 1-0 count. Now it turns to 1-1. Sanchez loads, deals, strike two. Now two balls, two strikes, a couple of outs as well with no one on for Farah. Sanchez delivers, breaking ball off the mark, full count. Payoff pitch, swung on, that one is towards center field. Martinez! Ooh. Jumping in the air, another leaping grab for the SNU outfield. Jacob Martinez finally gets SNU out of the top of the eighth. Now it's time to put runs on the board if you've got any hope left. Not quite now or never, but just about there.
Just about. Now, like I talked earlier in that inning, we were really hoping that we shut them down, but unfortunately, this Henderson State team just so efficient with the bats, able to execute whenever they need it. Very aggressive on the base paths. Just a combination of those things has really led up to this 11-3 lead.
So bottom of the eighth, SNU needs to get the offense rolling. Dias will lead things off, then Bufford and LeMay will follow. At 7-8-9 in the lineup. Last time up for Dias, he got around to third base eventually. It was followed by a single from Bufford, in which LeMay grounded out to second base to end the inning. That was all back in the sixth inning. And here in the eighth, you're going to need something similar from those three. Preferably no outs, though, as on the mound for Henderson State will be Matthew Heron out of Mountain Pine, Arkansas, a transfer from Rogers State. He's a senior this season, coming in with an ERA of 7-even. This season, he's allowed 7 earned runs in 9 innings. 5 hits. He's got 8 strikeouts in those 9 innings. 8 walks as well. So again, a guy working the outer parts of the plate. But a strikeout, almost a strikeout per inning, is an incredible place to be. He comes in hoping to be the closer and get things done for Henderson State. Max dies at the plate for the Crimson Storm, looking to keep hope alive in this season. First pitch to Dias. He pulled it. 1-0. Now the 1-0. To Dias on the way. An absolute heater from Heron.
You know, sometimes I wish we had a radar gun up here.
Yeah, I've been begging someone that listens to get us one, but they haven't yet. The 2-0 will turn to 2-1.
Nobody listens.
Two balls, one strike. Matthew Heron delivers. Dias able to touch it, make it 2-2. Tucker LeMay will chase that ball down from the backstop. Now the 2-2 from Heron. Matthew loads, deals. Dias fouls it off. Boy, Max just such a smart hitter. He knows every situation so well. Understands what pitch should be thrown. Now the 2-2. Dias pops it towards right field. It's going to get down and get by him. Max Dias headed to second. Jones couldn't stop it. It bounces by his glove. And Dias gets on. A leadoff double from the transfer from New Orleans University. And now Chance Bufford with no outs and a man on second. Count now against Bufford. Heron eyes second. On the stretch, he'll load and deliver. Off the mark, ball two. Two balls, no strikes. Heron deals. Bufford tips it.
Heavy hack on that one.
Chance flew out to right field in the fourth, hit a single in the sixth. Now the 2-1. Well off the mark, turns to three balls, one strike. Now the 3-1, Matthew Heron delivers. There's ball four. So Bufford will walk to first. Now Tucker LeMay with no outs. Runners on first and second at the plate. We'll have a conversation. Southern Nazarene's been waiting for a pitcher that they can break. Haven't seen it yet, and now even the spot you're in, this is familiar territory for Henderson State defensively today, and they've come out at just about every tough spot.
Now bat number two, Tucker LeMay.
Now LeMay up to the plate. He'll bat righty. He's got Entwistle on deck. No outs, runners on first and second.
Another great opportunity here for us and you to put some runs up on the board.
Heron loads, deals to LeMay. First pitch, called strike one. Now the 0-1. LeMay tips it.
Come on.
Now the 0-2 from Heron. LeMay towards left field. Got a hold of it. Line drive going to be caught by Holt. And Holt runners where they stand. Boy, the contact LeMay was looking for just didn't float the way he was hoping. Now Colby Entwistle to the plate. One out now on the board.
Really the type of hit you want, just it was straight to him.
Entwistle hoping for some success. He's got two singles today. First pitch, he'll tip it. Now the 0-1, off the mark, 1-1 count. The 1-1 from Heron to Entwistle, outside. Needs something to stay alive. Heron deals. And tough pitch catches Entwistle. A wave brings about strike two. Two balls, two strikes against Colby.
You know, just a little antsiness right there, especially on a 2-1. Hitters count. He was hoping for something in the strike zone.
Now the 2-2. Entwistle will get it into left field. Dias holds up on third. Base is loaded. So Entwistle hits his third single of the day to load the bases and bring up Blake Brinkmeyer. Brinkmeyer looking for his first hit of the day. He's been walked twice. One out, bases juiced. Brinkmeyer at the plate. Heron deals, ball one. Now the 1-0. Outside, ball two. Two balls, no strikes. Brinkmeyer working here against Matthew Heron, a senior out of Mountain Pine, Arkansas. Now the 2-0 on the way. Three balls, no strikes. Blake Brinkmeyer ahead in the count. Hicks on deck for the Storm. Now the 3-0 from Heron. That's ball four. He'll walk in a run.
I'd expect a mound visit.
Yeah, this looks like it's going to be the day for Matthew Heron after he loads the bases and then walks one in. Hicks is going to come on up to bat with a new pitcher on the mound. You know, Desmond, I'm not saying anything crazy here, but I am saying, you bring in a new pitcher, things don't go his way. You bring in the second new pitcher, if things don't go his way, you're starting to see trouble if you're Henderson State.
Absolutely, and something that we've seen a lot is efficiency from the pitchers from Henderson State, especially with Williams. And now it's kind of looks like it's falling off. And if you're SNU, that's exactly what you need, especially being down by so much, so late in the game. You really need a pitcher that can build up and give you a chance to get some hits up there, get some runs.
Yeah, and it looks like out on the mound is gonna be Mitchell Siegel. He's been a hitter for Henderson State.
The
today, and he's done well at that. But Siegel, gonna step into a new role on the mound. If I can see that again, I don't have my range. I can't see. That works as my binoculars, but I do believe that's who this is. He comes in an ERA of 2.92 this season. Excuse me, ERA of 8.72. That was his batting average. 8.72 ERA for Siegel. 21 and two-thirds innings pitched. 21 hits allowed. 21 earned runs as well. 15 strikeouts, 17 walks. Man. SNU, if you can break this, things are looking up.
Absolutely.
11-4 score. Bases will be juiced for Weston Hicks. Weston, last time up, hit an RBI single. And that was his first hit of the day. Jacob Martinez is on deck. Southern Nazarene trailing by 7. Desmond, what are you thinking here? Just in general.
Just in general, I would like to see SNU knock this guy out early, get a couple hits on him, get these runs batted in, because we really, really need it.
Yeah,
gotta
you're
keep
right.
Those tournament hopes alive.
Siegel, a 6'1 junior, transferred from Fort Scott Community College. Again, an 8.72 ERA against Weston Hicks here. Bases loaded. First pitch of the at-bat. Hicks takes a hack, foul ball. 0-1 now. I think you're right about coming out aggressive. Hoping to get rid of this guy early. One big swing could get in his head. Hicks had that in mind right there. Now the 0-1 outside. Again, Weston, a 261 average this year. The 1-1 rather on the way, high towards center field. This one shallow, could potentially put one on. It's gonna be caught. Bufford will have to head back to third. Two outs now on the board. Hicks couldn't get it done. And that's gonna bring up Jacob Martinez. Desmond, if you don't capitalize here, this game might be over.
I completely agree, especially with bases being loaded. In this situation, you got to have something.
You need at least two on. First pitch off the mark, 1-0.
You know, we talked about Siegel being from Fort Scott Community College. The Greyhounds.
Okay.
Kind of an interesting mascot. Not as interesting as the...
We'll never get over the Thunder Ducks or the Buckaroos. 1-0 count.
I love it.
Martinez at the plate. Nearly got hit. He dives away from that one. That ball was headed for his ankle. 2-0 count. Bases juice. Two outs on the board. Trey Orman on deck. 2-0 from Siegel. Now 3-0 as that one was outside. Now the 3-0 to Martinez. Ball 4. Siegel walks one in and brings Orman to the plate. Well, with that, bases remain loaded. Two outs. You feel like you got to put at least two on from this spot now. Trey Orman at the plate. Last time up, he hit a hard line drive towards left field. It was caught out of the air, but solid contact was made. Oh, 0-1 count to start us off.
Yeah, and right now, really not seeing the greatest outing from Orman in terms of hitting, but at the same time, he is fully capable of getting you exactly what you need.
Yeah, Orman's reached twice on fielder's choice. Grounded out to second, and again, hard line drive. to left field, which did score one, actually. Now the 2-1. Siegel, two balls, one strike, couple of outs. Base is loaded. The pitch on the way to Orman. Trey, foul ball. Now a 2-2 count against Orman. Two's hot. The 2-2 from Siegel. Orman lets it go by for ball three. It was at his eyes. Full count.
Big at bat right here.
Mitch Siegel brings in the payoff pitch on the ground towards short. Should be an easy play to first. And the throw on the money. Argenbright again handling business over a shortstop. Now, if you're SNU, you did get one on. You got two on, actually. But you need more.
You do indeed.
Well, Desmond, we're in the ninth inning. It's do or die time.
Absolutely.
And we talked about it earlier, not just for this game. Now, again, you can technically lose one and still make the tournament.
Yeah, and that's what we were talking about earlier. You know, there's a chance that if you do drop one that a couple things fall your way, but you really
this can't be the one.
Exactly.
Yeah, this cannot be the one. Oh, man. Tough spot here. Logan Isbell out to the mound. Isbell's going to come in and get ready to face Rice, Holt. And we'll see if Siegel still bats. He may be replaced. He was the DH coming in. We'll get a look at that. But Desmond, what are you expecting here from Henderson State?
Honestly, I expect Henderson State to do exactly what they've been doing all game. Just really efficient hitting, fighting off pitches that might not be exactly in the zone, but just getting those foul balls and really making these pitchers work for those strikeouts. And really, there hasn't been a lot of strikeouts today. I'm only seeing seven from both teams.
Yeah, not a ton of strikeouts today. Also not as many home runs as I thought we would see with the wind blowing out the way it is. Seen a couple, but other than that, not a single one from SNU or my dad. That I didn't expect.
Agreed.
Now the 0-1 from Isbell. That one swung on, will chop foul to the right side. Now the 0-2 on the way, it's off the mark, make it 1-2. Two balls, two strikes. First at bat of the inning. Rice at the plate, now 3-2. Full count. So the count runs full for Luke Rice. Louis Holt on deck. Well, that's a home run if I've ever seen one.
Wow.
Oh my goodness.
Oh,
that's in the pasture.
Gosh.
Oh my. Luke Rice. Is Luke nice? Good grief.
Grant, you know what the worst part is about that hit?
What?
It didn't look like he tried.
Well, he got every single piece of it. Wow. Jeez. Solo shot for Rice. Brings up Holt. Now a 12-5 ball game. The next pitch into the netting.
You know, with Rice, I'm pretty sure that's his first home run of the season. I could be wrong. I think we talked about that earlier.
It actually is his first home run, yeah. Good call. 1-0. Swung on. That one will get into right field. Now Lou Holt stands on first. Louis Holt.
I guess you could technically call him Lou.
You could. I won't.
I feel like
well,
that's
I did, but.
Accidentally. It was accidental.
Yeah. Wouldn't it be something if Lou Holt hit that? I think it would.
I think it would.
Oh, man. It's about that time of the game, isn't it? Jordan Allen at the plate, freshman out of Tatum, Texas. Comes in for Siegel. Allen, a six-footer, hitting .288 this season. Now 1-0 count. Wave for strike one. 1-1 count now, Isbell against Allen.
He's got four home runs to his name. Not somebody you want to hang something to.
No. 12-5 ball game. Right now, SNU needs to stop the bleeding. You still have a chance is the thing. Just have to get out of it. And, you know, what I'm looking at on the board, on the scoreboard in the facility. Am I mistaken, or does it say we scored six runs last inning? Because it says that, but also we have five runs total.
Oh.
Well, there's another home run. That one's over the scoreboard. Speaking of scoreboard.
You know, I mentioned his home
Allen,
run count.
Allen, the freshman, just hit a two-run shot.
That's going to be his fifth home run this season.
So Allen hits it over. Now Irvin will get a chance. Still no outs on the board for SNU this inning. Wow, 14-5 ball game. Isbell delivers. There's strike one. Alley 1 turns to 0-2. The 0-2 on the way off the mark. Y'all right?
I think Colby might have caught another one.
Yeah, he's taking a beating today, hasn't he? One ball, two strikes. Logan Isbell loads, deals. High and inside, 2-2.
Catcher is not an easy place to play at. And that's one of the reasons.
Yes. Now the 2-2 on the way. No good. Count runs full. Isbell, the payoff pitch. Swung on. That one will get down in left center field. At least a single. And it's going to hold as just that.
You know, I talked about it at the beginning of this inning when you asked me what I thought Henderson State was going to do. And, of course.
More of the same, yeah.
Doing exactly what they've been doing pretty much all game. Just efficiency.
Yeah, well, that's going to be the end of the day for Logan Isbell. Tough outing for Logan. But with that new face on the mound, it's going to be Tyler Reed, freshman out of Pampa, Texas. Tyler comes in again. He's touching 92 on his fastball. Again, a guy, we talked about it last time out. You get him comfortable, you get him in the zone, he'll deal for you. Just looking to get him in a spot where he feels comfortable where he is. Hopefully this is just that for him. 14-5 ball game. SNU looking to get things going because they need it right now. We'll take a break, step away, and be right back after this.
Renew is the University Counseling Center. We are located at 6710 Northwest 43rd Street, just north of the Webster Commons. Renew offers a variety of services, including individual counseling, couples counseling, and psychoeducational workshops. The first 5 sessions for students are free, and students will never pay more than $10 per session. Faculty counseling is just $40 per session. Renew is open Monday through Thursday from 9 a.m. to 8 p.m., and Fridays from 11 a.m. until 6 p.m. For more information, visit renew.snu.edu or email renew@mail.snu.edu.
Well, you bring you back in. You're going to see Tyler Reed at the rubber on the mound. 4 1/3 innings pitched this season. He's allowed 5 hits. And walked 9 batters and struck out 2. And a guy just hasn't felt comfortable yet. You feel like he's one game away from really breaking out, though. Touching 92 with his fastball. His changeup is just dirty. We'll see what he brings to Thomas, the 8-hole batter right here. Runner on first, no outs. First pitch from Reed, swing, miss, strike 1. Henderson State's already put 3 runs on the board this inning. They scored 3 runs in the last 3 innings. That ball's hit well. It's going to get down in left field, just out of the infield. That'll be a single. So Thomas gets to first, Irvin over on second, and Moore at the plate. Moore batting righty on the pitch. Turns to 0-1. Looks like Reed going simple early. Now the 0-1. Tyler deals. Breaking ball. Just off. One ball, one strike. Reed delivers. That one's going to bounce. Good block by Entwistle. Now the 2-1 from the freshman Reed. Pitch on the way, just outside. 3-1 count now. Three-one from Reed. There's strike 2. Full count. 2 runners on, no outs. Payoff pitch. Reed will miss. That one just got out of his hand. Slipped out, it looked like. So base is now loaded. Reed got to the full count after falling behind. Just got away from him on that one. Now Alex Day, redshirt senior out of Ashdown, Arkansas, transferred in from Louisiana State. First pitch today, called 1. Hey. That ball hit hard towards center field. Martinez under it at the wall. Jacob Martinez makes the catch. One out now on the board, but one more will score for Henderson State. Number 15 to 5 score. Southern Nazarene trails by 10. An RBI, rather a sack fly for Day. Now Argenbright to the plate. Argenbright hits that one well. Will it get down in right field? Got through by Brinkmeyer and Hicks. And so an RBI single for Argenbright. Now Reed facing Farah. First pitch to Farah. Will get by. It's going to hit the back wall. In whistle with the toss. Reed couldn't get there in time. Moore able to score. So 1-0 count. Runner on second. One out on the board. Reed delivers. That one will get to the back wall. 2-0 now. Now the 2-0. Tyler delivers just outside. 3-0. Tyler Reed, a well-liked guy on campus as well. Actually just got hired to be a resident advisor in one of the halls. And he'll walk Farah. Put runners on first and second. Looks like skipper Grant Ledbetter going to head on out and call it. Reed does get an out on the board. That's going to be the day for him. We'll see who they bring in after this. We'll step away. Be right back. You're watching SNU Baseball on the Call Sports Network. Well, a new face on the mound is Jake Scow, a senior out of Mustang, Oklahoma. Went to Mustang High School. He comes in. He's had two appearances this season, one against Harding, one at Oklahoma Panhandle State. Total of .2, so two-thirds innings pitched for him. He's allowed 8 hits, 7 earned runs, 1 walk, no strikeouts. He's given up 3 home runs and 2 doubles for an ERA of 94.5. Well, Desmond trailing by 11, rather 12. Southern Nazarene really just looking to end this inning, at least in the top half, and have a chance. Slim, slim, slim chance. But it's baseball.
It is baseball. There's always a chance.
There's always a chance. Until the game ends, then there's not a chance.
It's a small chance, but there's a chance nonetheless.
Oh, okay. Okay. Well, to the plate. It's going to be another new face for Henderson State. Jackson Gregg, the junior out of Keller, Texas. Typically a first baseman, standing 6'4". He'll check the first pitch. It'll be strike one. Gregg looking for his first hit on the season. He's got 10 at-bats, just hasn't gone his way. He's been walked 3 times. Now 1-1 count. Scow delivers outside, 1-2. Rather, 2-1. Jake Scow loads, deals, the 2-1 on the way. That's going to be the first hit of the season. And an RBI single will be the first hit for Jackson Gregg this year. So make it 18-5. With runners on the corners. One out on the board. And another new player to the plate, Julio Vasquez. Julio, the hometown of Cambridge, Ontario, Canada. Transferred in from Howard Junior College. 0-1 count. 185 average for Vasquez this season. He's got 5 hits. Now 0-2 count against him. He's also struck out 9 times. Now the 0-2. Scow deals. Got him looking. Jake Scow gets a strikeout for out number 2. And now Allen, who earlier this inning hit a 2-run bomb, is back to the plate. Surely he won't hit 2 in 1 inning, right?
Surely.
Surely. Don't call me Shirley.
I apologize.
1-0. Scow. On the stretch, delivers. That one on the ground is going to get through the infield. Brinkmeyer couldn't stop it in right field. So another run batted in. That's 3 RBIs now for Allen. With runners now on first and second. 2 outs, scores 19-5. Henderson State pouring it on. 8 runs scored in this inning for the Reddies. Scow steps off. So the question becomes, if you get this out, can you score 14 runs in 1 inning?
Grant, I've seen it done.
I've seen much crazier things from SNU baseball. I'll put it that way. 1-0 count. Pitch on the way. Now 2-0. Two balls, no strikes. Couple of outs. Runners on first and second. Top of the ninth. That ball might be gone if it stays fair. They'll say it does. And that's going to be a 3-run shot off the bat. Henderson ready. Oh, my goodness. Austin Scritchfield out of Cabot, Arkansas, sends it over. Good news and bad news. The good news is the bases were just cleared for you. The bad news, it was a home run, a 3-run shot. It's 22-5.
Grant, that was a moonshot.
It's a 22-5. I think it was. Okay, so the 20th hit of the day for Henderson State. Jake Scow remains on the bump. I think he's going to be the final pitcher of the day regardless for Southern Nazarene. Oh, man. That ball on the ground. This could be it for the top half. LeMay, no. Throw was high. Hicks couldn't hold on to it. Entwistle was there to back it up, so it remains a single. Good grief. Man, we're at the bottom of the lineup. Moore at the plate. Two outs, runner on first. Scow loads, deals. First pitch called, strike one. Now the 0-1 from Scow. That hurt.
Ow.
Moore takes it square in the back. Now two runners on. And Day comes to the plate.
Grant, you want to talk about a dead dugout? Nothing.
Well, how could there be? It's 22-5, Desmond. What do you want? Good grief. Hey, guys, let's go. It's 22-5. Oh, man.
Grant, I'm trying to be positive.
Desmond, come on now. 0-1. You know, I love SNU as much as the next guy, but when you look up and you see 20 hits to 8 and 3 errors on your side. Error strike 2. 1-2. I just feel like this is a setup for quite the comeback. One ball, two strikes, couple of outs. That one up the middle. Scow going to scoop it. Scow finally ends the inning for Southern Nazarene. Prayers have been sent up, and they've finally been answered. 22-5 the score, bottom of the ninth. Here we come. These are the moments you live for. These are the moments you live for if you're Southern Nazarene University. You've got a chance to do the impossible. It's going to take a miracle. But you're a Christian school. We'll get into it after this break. We'll be back after this. Well, we bring you back into Phelan Field. 22-5 is your score. Good news and bad news. The good news is you're in the meat of your lineup. You've got Hudson coming up with Dias and Bufford on deck. The bad news is just the scoreboard. 22-5.
Just the scoreboard in general. That's it.
Yeah, hey, look. Here's the deal, okay? If you put up 17... you're tied up.
Yeah.
There is a number. There is a number.
That number is not impossible to reach.
The number might be pretty big, but it is a number. Chase Hudson, can he get it started?
Grant, we'll see. I'm going to be honest. I don't think we'll count to 17.
Oh, man. You can't count it. Desmond, you're in college, man. How'd you get here?
I don't know.
A one count. I'm a broken man. The 0-1 turns to 0-2. You know, I know for a fact that a lot of times opposing teams would go listen to the broadcast, especially after a big win, and just say, I wonder how they dealt with it. Just know you broke me if you go back, if you're listening to it.
We're not doing great up here.
The 0-2, now 1-2. That one was high. However, if you get something going here, I'll be excited all over again.
Lift the spirits a little bit.
It doesn't take much for me to get pumped up. I'm just going to be honest.
That's because you're fired up on bangs.
I am. I'm very caffeinated right now. The 1-2. Hudson on the ground toward second base, scooped up, and the throw on the money. First out on the board for Galvin. Ryan Galvin, a senior out of Texarkana, Texas. Brother Alex Galvin also on roster. He's a sophomore. But one out now on the board is going to bring up Dias. First pitch, called ball one. It ain't over.
It ain't over till it's over.
I didn't hear no bell. The 1-0. Now 1-1. Now a 2-1 count, Max Dias. Two balls, one strike, working here against Ryan Galvin. A 2-1, Dias towards center field. Max Dias really got a hold of that one, but it's gonna be caught as on the move in center field. Well, who even's out there anymore after all these changes? It's still Moore. Moore makes the grab. Two outs now on the board. Two out hitting has been big for SNU this season. It could be huge here.
It has to be.
Chance Buffer at the plate. Galvin loads, delivers. First pitch, ball one. LeMay on deck. The 1-0 on the way. Buffered high towards first base. Out of play. Will fall foul. One ball, one strike. Couple of outs, no one on. Now the 1-1. Buffer fouls it off. 1-2. Now the 1-2 from Galvin to end the ball game. The wave, the miss, he got him swinging. Ryan Galvin ends it on a strikeout, and Southern Nazarene unable to make the comeback. 22-5, the final score in game one of this three-game series. Desmond, ouchie, is an understatement.
It's a great understatement. I mean, just looking at some of the stats, I mean, 12 left on base, only five RBIs, just really not a lot going for us this game, and I think everybody in that SNU dugout understands that.
Yeah, and you know what really hurts about this game specifically, is Levi Graham came in, took the starting role, and more than did his job.
Absolutely. Except for kind of a rough first inning,
that wasn't on him.
Exactly. And we even got one back in that first inning. But just him being extremely efficient in those next innings and then him getting pulled And then it kind of just took off from there for Henderson State.
Yeah, through four, maybe even five or six innings, you felt like, man, we're right there. And again, we talked about it so much. You felt like, oh, we're just really poking and prodding at this pitching staff. Something is bound to break, and it just never did for SNU. Southern Nazarene left 12 runners on base in this ball game, as opposed to Henderson State's five, and had 10 less at-bats. That's the thing right there, 10 less at-bats. Obviously, 20 hits to eight is very telling as well. What's interesting to me, though, in 20 hits, Henderson State had two doubles. Only two doubles. We saw a lot of bunts go for singles. We saw a lot of just bloopers into the outfield, right?
Yeah.
Consistent, controlled hitting was the story for Henderson State.
It absolutely was. A lot of efficiency coming from that side. A lot of execution. That's something that they were really great at today, is execution, and something that SNU really was not. I mean, it's plain and simple.
Yeah, absolutely. Hey, that ninth inning saw 11 runs on the board for the Reddies. That really just sealed it. Three runs in the eighth, two in the seventh for Henderson State. Henderson State, by the way, once the fifth inning hit, they scored in every single inning from that point on. Good news and bad news, Desmond. I'll give you the bad news first.
Okay.
This one hurts bad.
It does.
And it really puts a damper on your hopes of the postseason. The good news, we're right back here tomorrow, baby, for Senior Day.
Woo!
Two games, doubleheader. It's going to be so fun. We'll be live. I just dropped something. It was a stool.
I just knocked
a stool over. What are we doing? You know, we just knocked a stool over. We'll be live probably about 11:30-ish for Senior Day activities, but after that, we'll go live and we will have a blast. I'm Grant McNew. That's Desmond Williams saying it's been a pleasure to have you along. We'll see you tomorrow.